Hey there, I'm Mike Dancy, and I make review videos about items that have buttons and batteries. This has both. It is the Totem electric mountain bike, and I'm having a blast with it. It's been so much fun. So let's go take a closer look at it, and we'll get this review started. What do we have in here? Holy crap, it's an electric mountain bike. An electric mountain bike. This is going to be a lot of fun. Let's put it together. Now, this does include a manual. You would think by now that the companies would have learned that I don't actually read manuals. But it is an electric bike, and I guess I should spend a few minutes with the manual just to make sure that I don't butcher this. But I think I'll figure it out. This isn't my first bicycle that I've built. All right, let's get to it.
Battery and keys.
Now, like most things that require batteries, it uses the charger. This is a big giant charger because that's a big giant battery and it draws a lot of juice. So make sure that when you plug this in, you're plugging it into the wall, not a power bar, because this may actually overheat a power bar and that could be dangerous. So just be careful, okay? Now the brand on this bike is Totem. It's owned by Bike Work Canada. They've been in business for over 35 years. You can find more at bikeworkca.com. And originally, this bike was $1,199 Canadian dollars, but for viewers of this channel, they reduced the price to $899. Just use the link in the description. A few things I want to mention about it. It has a 350-watt rear motor. It has a 104-amp-hour lithium-iron battery. It has a maximum speed of 32 kilometers per hour, and it covers between 30 to 60 kilometers. It also has Shimano drivetrain with 21 speeds, a suspension fork, disc brakes, a kickstand, and a really comfy seat. It's just so much fun to ride. Okay, so we are in pedal mode right now. I'm just cycling comfortably along here.
To get it started, you press and hold the power button briefly. Press the plus button, and there's your assist. And then I just squeeze the throttle.
When you start, it's the hardest part. I rode all the way out here and I forgot the damn SD card for my camera, so now I gotta go back. Or maybe I can shoot in here, hard to say. We're gonna go up this little incline here to see if I can carry my fat ass up this hill. So far, it's okay. A little slow.
So small hills like this aren't really a problem. Though I can notice the bike going a little slow when I get up here.
I don't need the pedal. What am I pedaling for? I don't need the pedal.
It's a pretty tight turn radius.
It accelerates pretty quickly. It's not gonna blow your socks off, but still. And the brakes are so nice. And it just goes anywhere. You know, if I was a bit more younger and a bit more daring, then maybe I would feel, well, I feel pretty comfortable on it as is. And I don't ride a lot. So I think this bike is more than enough for anybody that's just going to use it to commute or have a bit of fun with. I do like that little bit of kick when you're going up the hills, I'll tell you. Anyway, I like this. Good marks. Well, I've had the bike now for a few days. I've ridden it so far. I've just gone everywhere with it, and I've been just having a blast with it. It's just really comfortable. It does have three main features. So it has the pedal assist, which is where you're riding along and you just keep pedaling, and if you reach like an incline or anything, it pulls you up it really nicely. It comes with fully automated, which is when you get going a little bit, you crack the throttle, and then it just rolls. It just keeps rolling for you, which is great on flats or anywhere that you want to commute to. And it has something called push mode, which I also found quite nice, because I found that there's areas, especially when I'm off-road, and I get into a deep hill, and it just doesn't have enough gas to get me up the hill, and I don't have enough gas because I'm fat. So when I get off the bike and I press the push button, it rolls itself up the hill and pulls anything I have on it. Speaking of pulling, you can mount on the back here a carrier. And I can carry your backpack, your briefcase, or your groceries, or whatever it is that you want to use this for. I think that this is a great commuter bike. It's a great beginner e-bike. It's going to be good if your kids are in university or college or high school and they want something to go back and forth. This can be great for commuting them, and it will save them from getting all hot and sweaty on the way. Keep in mind though that this is a heavy bike. It weighs a lot. So if your commute involves you going up and down stairs, this could be really heavy. And when you go to lock it up, it does have a quick release front hub, a quick release seat, and those can be removed and taken really quickly. So if you're gonna lock it up, be sure to lock those up. Now I'm going to leave a more detailed review on my website at mikedancy.com. I'll have some added videos on there that aren't in this video here. You'll get more detail. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comments. I can't wait to test another one of these. I hope that they make another model like this, but with a 500 watt motor instead of the 350 watt, because that would allow it to go a little bit faster or have a bit more torque on hills. All right, I'm going to go for a ride. The weather's beautiful. Thanks for watching. We'll talk soon. My knees. Ah.
Not over the ravine though, because that would be incredibly fun but stupid.